Hi everyone, welcome back to our YouTube classes. I am your Somchika sir from Kumadwati Science and Commerce PU College, Shikaripura. In this session, I am going to present you the second unit of your English language, that is Two Deer, written by Leo Tolstoy. Dear students, before getting into the chapter, let's look into the brief introduction about the author. Leo Tolstoy is a Russian poet and who writes the primarily short stories and novels. Leo Tolstoy is very famous for his two long narratives. The one is War and Peace, published in the year of 1869, and the second one is Anna Karenina, published in the year of 1877. In this chapter, Two Deer, Leo Tolstoy focusing on inefficiency of the government to bring out its verdict. And Leo Tolstoy is very famous for his paradoxical complicated persona, and he is a social thinker and social reformer. Okay, let's look into the chapter Two Deer. In this chapter, he brought out a lot of sarcasm. Through the humor, he bring out the Two Deer chapter. It focusing on loose point of the government to converts its verdict to procedure. So throughout the procedure of converting the verdict to the punishment, they made lot of alternate, one after one, and they made a lot of changes after changes. So here he clearly shown that in a humorous way in this chapter about the failure of the government. Okay, let's look into the title, Two Deer. What do you mean by Two Deer with the exclamatory mark? As for the grammatical meaning of the deer is adorable, lovable, very kind person. But here, deer along with the exclamatory mark is there. What did it mean? Two Deer, as for your chapter concern, it is an expensive person. Expensive person. How? Later you come to know at the end of the chapter. Okay. Look at the chapter. It chapters start with like this, describing the Monaco kingdom. Okay. Near the borders of France and Italy, on the shore of the Mediterranean Sea, lies a tiny little kingdom called Monaco. Look at here. In the beginning of the chapter, Leo Tolstoy gave a description about the kingdom, Monaco kingdom. So Monaco kingdom is located near the borders of France and Italy on the shore of the Mediterranean Sea. It lies a tiny kingdom, tiny in the sense a small kingdom. It is its location. Many a small country town can boast more inhabitants than this kingdom, for there are only about 7,000 of them all told, and if all the land in kingdom were divided, there would not be an acre for each inhabitants. Look at, dear students, in the toy kingdom only 7,000 people are there, only 7,000. Okay, if you look into the Shikaripura town, in Shikaripura city itself, more than 25,000 people are there. But in that kingdom, only 7,000 people are there. It is a small, a toy kingdom. Okay. Then here, if the king would like to divide the entire landmass of the Monaco, even the inhabitants of that Monaco kingdom didn't get an acre for them. So it is a small, tiny kingdom, very less in population, very less in land mass, and still the Monaco kingdom is existed, the Monaco country is existed, and it is the second smallest country of the world after the Vatican City. Look what happened later. But in this toy kingdom, there is a real king, Glatt. And he has a palace and courtiers and ministers and bishop and general and an army. Look, it is a small kingdom, tiny kingdom, only 7,000 people are there, and most importantly, it is very less in a land mass. But in that kingdom, as elsewhere in the other kingdom, what are the aspects are there, like palace, kinglet, courtiers, ministers, bishops, army, generals, everybody is there in that kingdom. Look at here, bishop, one who look towards the religious aspects, including from them all the persons and the ministries, courtiers, everybody is there in that kingdom as elsewhere in the other kingdom. So here it is not a generals and an army. So when you think about the army, you might get confused, because only 7,000 people are there. What can they have army? Is it necessary for like that? But in the kingdom, they have army, and it is not in a large army here. Look at the description of the army. It is not a large army, only 60 men in all, but still it is an army. Look at here, in our classes, more than 80 students will be there. But in that kingdom, Monaco kingdom, there is an army, and it consists only 60 men. It is an army, but not in a large number. When we compare to our Indian army, we have a large number of soldiers in our army. But here, as for your syllabus concern, and as for the toy kingdom Monaco concern, only 60 men are there in that army. There are also taxes in this kingdom as elsewhere, a tax on tobacco and on wine and spirits, and a poll tax. Usually in that Monaco kingdom, as elsewhere in the other kingdom and other countries, we are going to collecting the tax from the people. In just example, take an example of India. In India, we are going to pay a tax, VAT and GST for all the products which we are going to buy. As elsewhere in that Monaco kingdom, the king and the kinglet of the Monaco, they would like to receiving the taxes. Here, the king is receiving the taxes from the tobacco, wine, spirits and poll tax. Here, look here, this poll tax is means individual tax. Poll tax means individual tax. Then, but though the people, they drink and smoke as people do in the other countries, there are so few of them that the prince would have been hard put to it to feed his courtiers and officials and to keep himself if he had not found a new and special source of revenue. Look, in the toy kingdom, the kinglet of the Monaco used to collect the tax on tobacco, wine, spirits and poll tax. But although it is not sufficient to him to maintain his kingdom, because he need to pay the salary for courtiers, ministers, bishops, general and soldiers, and himself he need to lead a luxurious life, because he is a king of the Monaco kingdom. So it is not sufficient, those money which is collecting by the all these things, spirits, wine and tobacco, poll tax, it is not sufficient to feed his courtiers and ministers and etc. all these things. That is why he found a new source of revenue. So that is why he found a new source of revenue here. What is that? He found a new special source of revenue. This special revenue come from gaming house. Look here, why he looked forward towards the special source of revenue? Because he need to feed his courtiers, ministers, bishops, general and army. That is why those taxes were not sufficient him to maintain all of them. That is why he found a new special source of revenue, and that special source of revenue come from gaming house. Look at here, this special revenue come from gaming house. Gaming house is nothing but a gambling house where people play roulette. Look, the Monaco kingdom and the kinglet received the special source of revenue from the gaming house. In the gaming house, the people of the Monaco or any other European country people, they used to play roulette. It is one kind of a game that they are going to play in that gaming house or the gambling house. So roulette is a play, it is one kind of a game. People play, and whether they win or lose, the keeper always gets a percentage on the turnover, and out of his profits he pays a large sum to the prince. Look how the Monaco king receiving the special source of revenue from the gaming house. Here the keepers of that gaming house, they would like to open the gaming houses in their house, maybe in the particular places. Here people will play, whether they win or lose, the keepers of that gaming house gets a lot of benefit, profit from that turnover, and out of that profit the keepers of the gaming house have to pay a large sum amount to the prince. So here prince receiving a lot of money from the gambling houses. So like this, he is earning the money to feed his courtiers, ministers, bishops and an army. Look what happened later. The reason he pays so much is that it is the only such gambling establishment left in Europe. So you might get a question, why the keepers of the gaming house pay large sum amount to the king of that Monaco? You might get a question of this. What was the reason behind that? It is very clearly, in entire European continent, only in Monaco kingdom gambling houses are establishment, and he gave a permission to open the gaming house in his kingdom. For that reason, here the keepers of the gaming house paid lot of money, a large sum of money, in the name of special source of income to the king. This is the reason behind that. Some of the look at here. The reason he pays so much is that it is the only such gambling establishment left in Europe. Some of the little German sovereign used to keep gaming houses of the same kind, but some years ago they were forbidden to do so. You might ask me, why sir other country in that European continent didn't open? Some years ago they gave permission to open the gambling houses, but what happened later? They forbade it. It means they prohibited, they closed it. What was the reason behind that? Because this kind of a gaming houses did harm lot of so much to the society. Look at here. The reason they were stopped was because these gaming houses did so much harm. Look, some German sovereign countries gave a permission to open the gambling houses, but later some years ago they closed it. Because what was the reason here? This is the very clear mentioned here. The reason they were stopped, because these gaming houses did so much harm. In term of what? In term of how? Look at here. A man would come and try his luck, then he would risk all he had and lose it. Then he would even risk money that did not belong to him and lose that too. And then in despair he would draw or shoot himself. Look, usually what happened in the gaming houses? In the gaming houses, the people will go and pay the roulette by using their earned money. What happened during that game? They lost their money. So they do not stop there. What they will do? They will take a loan by his friend or anyone else, and risking the loan money also. And finally, what is the result? They are losing that too. So he lost the earned money and the loan money itself. What happened? In despair, in very sad, because he lost in the game. What they are going to do? They are going to committing a suicide by shooting themselves or drawing themselves or hanging themselves. So for this reason, some German sovereign countries prohibited the gambling houses, because they do not want to make money in that bad way. So today in this contemporary world also, some people are addicted towards the gambling. They used to play gambling like cards and some other things. But what is the result? They lost everything. So as elsewhere, here also in the European continent, they were forbade the gambling house itself. But look at here, what happened later? So the German forbade their rulers to make money in this way, but there was no one to stop the Prince of Monaco, and he remained with the monopoly of the business. So the German sovereign countries and the European countries were forbade their rulers to make money in such kind of a bad way. Gambling is a bad way here. But who will going to ask the and question the king of the Monaco? No one would like to question him because he is the king of that country. And he had a monopoly over that business, over that gambling house. Here they will ask one last question here. So who had the monopoly over the gambling house or the roulette? Here the king of the Monaco or the kinglet of the Monaco had a monopoly over that gambling house. What do you mean by monopoly? Monopoly means single ownership about that game. Okay, he had a single ownership. Because except the Monaco kingdom, none other country were gave a permission to open the gambling house here. So now, everyone who wants to gamble goes to Monaco. Whether they win or lose, the prince gains by it. Look here, in the European continent itself, if they want to play roulette, they used to go to the Monaco. Whether they win or lose, that doesn't matter here. But who is getting a profit here? The king of the Monaco is getting a profit here. You can't earn stone palace by honest labor. Look at here, it is a very famous proverb. You can't earn a stone palace by honest labor. As the proverb says, and the kinglet of Monaco knows it is a dirty business. But what is he to do? He has to live and draw revenue from drink and from tobacco is also not nice thing. So he lives and rings and rakes in the money and holds his court with all ceremonies of a real king. So this is the reason why Monaco king, although he knew that gambling is a dirty business, he knew it is a dirty business, but he gave a permission to open it. What was the reason behind that? Because he need to live as like a real king. He need to maintain his court, maintain his courtiers, maintain his bishops, maintain his army. He need money. So in order to look into the landmass, Monaco kingdom has considered a very less landmass. And only 7,000 people are there. How could he get a revenue? How could he lead a luxurious life without finding this kind of a money? So that is why this proverb says here, you can't earn a stone palace by honest labor. So if he goes on with the honesty in that kingdom, he wouldn't get anything. For agriculture, he didn't get a good land. In the sense, land mass is very less. As for the data, it is only 2.02 square kilometer. And 7,000 people are there. He need to feed everyone. He need to look after all the things, aspects. That is why, although he knew that the gambling is a dirty business, but he gave up permission to open it. Look, so he lives and reigns. Reigns representing, he makes administration in that Monaco kingdom, and he rakes. Rakes representing here, he plus the money. He would like to collect the money from the tobacco tax, spirits, wine and everything, and also from the special source of revenue. So he is collecting the money and spending that to maintain his kingdom. Look, and along with rakes in the money and holds his court with all the ceremonies of a real king. So he would like to maintain that luxurious life, and he would like to hold his court with all ceremony of a real king. This is the reason why he had received the lot of taxes from the tobacco, wine and gaming houses. This is the reason. Okay, look what happened later. He has his coronation. So he wanted to hold his court with us all ceremonies as a real king. So what are the ceremonies he would like to had in his kingdom? Look at here, he has his coronation. So coronation, what we call as so the Ang son will going to take a crown. Pattabhisheka, if you let a call in that, Yuvaraja Pattabhisheka. His leaves, he would like to meet all the ministers, courtiers and bishops and everyone. He rewards. Look, as a king, he would like to reward. If anybody makes a good deed, he would like to give him a rewards. Either to take a 10 piece of gold or silver, something else. And he also would like to make sentence. Here sentences, it means punishment. He would like to give a punishment. To execute that punishment, he needs money. Later we come to know, sentence is very much discussed throughout the chapter here. And pardons, he would like to also going to excusing to the persons. And he also has his reviews, councils, laws and court of justice. Just like other kings, only all on a smaller scale. Look, he had everything. Court of law, justice, judge, courtier, minister, bishop and everything. As like other kings, but it is in a smaller scale. Just look at the army, the Morocco kingdom army, it consists 60 men. But what about Indian army? It consists more than 1 lakh people, soldiers. So he had everything, but in a smaller scale. This is the description of the Monaco kingdom. And it is a toy kingdom. Why it is a toy kingdom? Because it is ruled by the kinglet. And the kingdom is consist very less landmass and very less population. Only 7,000 people are there. So up to here it is a description of the Monaco king and the kingdom. Look at here what happened later. Now it happened a few years ago that a murder was committed in this toy prince domain. So our actual story starts from here. And our actual sarcasm of the Leo Tolstoy and his humor start from here. So how? Now it happened a few years ago that a murder was committed in this toy prince domain. A murder committed. The people of the kingdom are peaceable and such a thing had not happened before. Look, the Monaco kingdom people were very peaceable and they even didn't encourage the non-violence. But what happened? A murderer was committed in that toy prince domain. Domain in the sense in that kingdom. The judges assembled with a much ceremony and tried the case in the most judicial manner. Okay. After the murderer, so here the murderer brought before the law, court of Monaco and the law. And the judges were tried the case in the most judicial manner. And finally what happened? There were judges and prosecutors and jurymen and barristers. So these members were together. They tried to bring out the most judicial manner of that case. Later, they argued and judged, and at last they condemned the criminal to have his head cut off as the law directs. And finally, all the judges, prosecutors, jurymen and barristers, in this lawyers, they discussed it together. And finally, as the Monaco kingdom law directs, they brought the verdict, that is, they wanted to head cut off the criminal, or they wanted to death the criminal. So look here, so far so good. Next they submitted the sentence to the prince. So in monarchy system, what are the decision has to take or have to take, that will be finalized by the king itself. So here the barrister, juryman and all the judges, they had taken the decision to head cut off the criminal, of that murderer. And finally they submitted their verdict to the king. And look here, the king accepted it, okay, read the verdict, and he said, if the fellow must be executed, executed him. Look, the king told to the judges, yes, he made a crime and he made a murderer here. The fellow must be executed, so he is not ready to live here. He must be executed, execute him. He also agreed that one. Look, the king also agreed, and the judges, barristers, lawyers and jurymen were all also agreed to head cut off the criminal. But when they are proceeded to execute him, there they found a lot of problems. Dear students, what are the problems they faced? So how they changed their verdict? Whether they executed the criminal? Question mark. In the next video, I would like to explain how the Monaco kingdom or the Monaco government brought changes after changes to execute that verdict. Later, in the next video, I will explain it. So, if you have any doubt, comment me in the comment box. where you didn't get the point or where you didn't understand it. Okay, I'll repeat you. If you like the video, hit the like button and share the video for your friends and others too. Have a nice day. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.